at long last, I've gotten around to watching the whole feature film of Way of the Dragon from start to finish. Why this is an accomplishment for me is that as a child, I would adore action movies so much that I would skip right through the movie to get to the action. Similar to how a dog chews on a bone because it wants the marrow, not because it's particularly attached to its bony taste. But in this case, the skip option on my remote gave me a straw. And once I discovered this delicious movie marrow, I would binge watch it for weeks like most adults do on Netflix with Game of Thrones, except mine was only 20 minutes of footage set on repeat. I would continue this process until my juvenile mind would become distracted, then latch onto something shiny. Why, my dear viewers, I advise you do not do the same with this film, is that you will miss all of the following. Old women checking out Bruce Lee. Old men checking out Bruce Lee. Gay men checking out Bruce Lee. Straight women checking out Bruce Lee. And of course, Bruce Lee checking out Bruce Lee. Don't lie, you're doing it too. But if I may direct your attention back to this very first scene shown in this masterpiece in all its unedited glory. Now, please keep in mind how many people had to watch past this in order to see anything of value in this movie. Just think about it. One moment, I'm gonna get myself a cup of coffee. Okay, guys, I'm back. Oh my gosh, it's still going. The silence is hurting me. Can we get some music up in this clip? Great Guile's theme on a Kung Fu sandwich. It does go with everything. So it goes without saying, you don't go to a martial arts flick for the plot any more than you would go to a Starbucks to get good coffee. You're there for the unexplained and unadulterated kicking of butts, and in the case of Starbucks, the free Wi-Fi. I had another analogy up my sleeve, but this scene kind of blows that out of the water. Wink, wink, nudge, nudge. But in the action sense, this movie does not disappoint. Unless, of course, you're a Chuck Norris fan. Spoilers! And I suppose the actual story wouldn't be so bad if it just didn't suck more than a mosquito in a full metal jacket holding a golf ball and a garden hose while listening to Beauty and the Beat by Justin Bieber and Nicki Minaj remixed by DJ Vacuum. It's Michael Jackson bad. That being if bad was used in its original English context. It's about a restaurant owned by a sketchy old man who may or may not inexplicably stab to death his entire management for no apparent reason by the end of this spoilers? It's way too late for this. This restaurant is run by a bunch of useless sandwich bags named...
Hey, 我叫 Tony. Jimmy.
Thomas.
Robert.
我没有英文名字,叫我阿全好,
thank you. Who do know actual work, don't clock in, and can't go a single scene without removing their shirts in a suggestive manner to display abs as noticeable as the invisible boatmobile. SpongeBob reference, so they're very... professional? Luckily, they're about as lovable as a brown recluse spider, and you'll feel no attachment to them when they're brutally, spoilers, murdered. Sorry. Anywho, the antagonists are a gang of gangsters who have the character depth of a puddle after being vaporized by the sun. They also make jokes like this.
May I help you? May you help me? Sure. I like some Chinese spare beef. Chinese spare rib? You mean to tell me you don't know what Chinese spare ribs are?
No, what's a Chinese spare rib?
Well, let me show you.
What's it look like? Oh, sorry. That's racist. They have no character. They really want the restaurant. I mean, really, really badly. SpongeBob reference number two. But the family, at least I think that's what they are, refuses to sell it on the grounds that they don't want to. But dudes, they want to buy it from you. They're not taking it. I mean, you're making zero to nothing pay on this trash heap, and the interracial mafia is willing to pay you for it? where do I sign? I mean, why the heck not? It's not even explained why this place is so important or why either one wants it, and it's just, yeah, really forced conflict. Then Bruce Lee arrives to fulfill the prophecy I read on the back of this cover. I have already expressed myself on this topic. Ah, now here's a category I can sink my teeth into. The reason that I love Bruce Lee films so much is that the fighting is just so real. Well, as real as fictional story can be anyways. This guy isn't using ropes, wires, or even steroids. And the footage is actually slowed down so their cameras can pick him up, he's that fast. Awesome. Not to mention they kept camera angle switching to a bare minimum. Most people would consider the strategy crap, but honestly, it shows they have nothing to hide. Except a sleeping cameraman on the other end of the lens. For example, in Transformers Anything, I couldn't tell you what the actual Autobot was going on, with the constant changing of shots like the director was singing lyrics to a Little John song. You'd think it would show you more, but it actually conceals a lot. And then there's the real reason you're here today, the battle that put Chuck Norris' facts to rest and left the solid truth that Bruce Lee messed him up more than Michael Bay messed up Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles. A moment of silence for my childhood. Moment over. These fight scenes are actually pretty fantastic, cause Bruce just has this look to him, you know, something in the eye. I just can't quite put my finger on it. But in those 5 minutes when he's whooping up on something, the whole plot seems believable and lets the audience know that it's on like Donkey Kong and the Legend of the Crystal Coconut in my next review. Spoilers! And for those of you who thought the other characters couldn't hold up on their own, suck on this. I get him. Awesome. Also, there's a cat. If at all possible, every person should see this movie, especially people between the ages of 1 to 96. Not 97, we don't like you. Why? Because it's inspiring! It makes you want to get up and do something fantastic, like master the no shadow kick, break stones with your bare hands, or even just touch your toe. If you want the awkward laugh, you can watch the story, but pick up a driver and screw that. This movie as a whole receives a 4 at best, but the action alone, when set to the side, is an 8 out of 10. Now if you'll excuse me, I'm feeling a little parched. I'ma get me some WHAT'S UP!